Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. I hope you're doing all fine. So before we start, as usual, I'm not a financial advisor, and all the content and information in this video is my own opinion and my own market observation. So let's dive here into the 4 hours chart. As you can see, we have this huge big candle to the upside here, and we pushed through the resistance box that we had here. So right now we are consolidating here above the resistance box, and what was before resistance is now acting as a support. So I believe that we're gonna stay at least in this level here for quite a while, at least till we retest here the bottom of the support channel. We might see some pushes to the upside and maybe here create another higher high, maybe around 5600, because you see that I draw here this channel with this support line here at around 5k now, and here the resistance, which should be right now at around 5600. So if we see a pump to the upside, I think that probably we're gonna stop here at this resistance point, maybe have some weeks to the upside, but that right here I think will be the top out if we see a big pump to the upside, a continuation from this. The thing is that we are not sure yet if this is a bear flag, this channel here, or just a continuation, just a bull flag and to the upside. But generally, when we see like this, the price climbing up, like we have right now, this usually tend to be a bear flag and should break to the downside. So I believe that if this is a bear flag, we should go straight down to at least 4400 or even 4200, probably more 4400 first. So right now I'm still waiting for the correction to happen to the downside, and as long as we don't have here the breakout from this channel, we cannot say if this is the beginning of the next bull run and the bull rally, or we are just inside a big bear flag and that we have soon the correction to the downside to at least 4400. Also, the weekly chart, you can see yesterday we drawn this line here that what if Bitcoin just repeat what did in all of the year 2018, where we had the top at 20k and then always retraced back up to the 0.618 Fibonacci line. So if this we're gonna repeat again, then right now the move is over and we should see a retest of the 3k and down, and then another bounce back up. It's not yet confirmed, but it's in the card because we are totally overbought in many time frames, like the weekly and the daily. But in the weekly, we still didn't have this bearish cross here in the stochastic RSI, and the RSI is at 56. So as long as we don't reach at least 70 in the RSI, we are not yet overbought. But in the stochastic RSI, we are already at the top at 100. So right now we should have a breakout here of the EMA ribbon and go to the upside and then push straight up to 6k. So this would start, I think, the next bull rally. But if we're gonna get rejected here and the RSI goes lower than 50, and also here we have a bearish cross, then I think the correction just started and we're probably gonna go down till all the technical indicators cool down to oversold conditions. But right now we are totally overbought and still continue like that, so we need more pushes to the upside so that FOMO kicks in, so that people start to make again profits, start to talk to their friends and everyone that they're making profits and they should buy now Bitcoin when we reach again 6k and higher. So at that point I think it's gonna be a very, very fast rally up to at least the highs where we were before here at 20k. Probably 20k also will be surpassed pretty fast if we see here a beginning of the next rally at this point here, because I think as soon as 6k is broken to the upside, there is almost no limits. But right now we are still down here, so nothing is nothing is decided yet. So just keep an eye what's gonna happen here, if we're gonna break here up to 6k or not, because if we break it, it's gonna be very bullish. If we're not gonna break it now, I think a re not just a correction, but maybe even a retest to 3K is very, very possible. So keep an eye on that. Because of this potential bear flag right now, I'm not gonna go all in or with big trading orders here, long or short. I'm just always scalping a bit the price here, doing some small profits in the very short term, like in the 1 minute chart, as you can see. Also here we can go a little bit in the past. I just show you in every video that this method is quite useful if you want to do some little day trading and not keep orders for a very long time open. Like here we just see we were over 1 second, we were overbought. I could have shorted here and take our profits down here as soon as the RSI cooled down. Same is if here you would have longed at the bottom here when we were oversold. So you can go back in time many, many times. So like here, exactly here. Also when we broke down below 30, you could have longed. When you go in such moments, when you go long or short, sometimes I also do market orders. Because anyway, the entry will be quite good around this area, even if we drop lower, but the entry will be good. If you put in here with the limit orders in BitMEX, then most of the times maybe your order will not be executed, or the system is overloaded and cannot enter you cannot enter your order. So market orders usually just execute immediately, but you're not sure exactly what kind of price you will get. Most of the times it's good, but of course can vary a few dollars when you have a fast movement to the upside or downside. Here as well, you see oversold here in the RSI. So if you would have longed around this area here, you could have closed it somewhere around here. Yeah, even if you missed that and the RSI went back down, you still could have closed it here with some profit. So you usually have enough time to do that. But you always have to be on the computer, sitting on the computer when you do these short trades like that. You cannot just open and leave it for a few hours unless you put a closing order with some little profits, and then you just let it execute when the price is reached. Okay, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. I hope you're in a good trade and see you all in the next one. Bye.